When we talk about financial risk management, we really can't avoid talking about risk and return. That's the end goal here, right? We want to maximize return while minimizing risk. That is, in essence, the whole premise of this whole lesson. Now, what is risk? It is generally uncertainty. If anything was certain, it wouldn't be risky. With markets, even if you know something's going to go down, which is not good, the certainty makes it less risky because you know it's going to happen. That is really our key here. Whenever you think risk, think uncertainty. It's the chance of financial loss. And like I said, even if you know a market is going to go down, you can always short it and use derivatives. We'll talk about that and what that means. So risk really is uncertainty. Uncertainty creates fear. Fear creates financial loss. With greater risk comes greater returns. With less risk comes less returns. We'll talk about this more and more, but right, a government bond is generally considered to be a risk-free investment. We'll see that throughout the exam. Risk-free rate is the treasury bond yield, and a treasury bond, that is a bond where the government's borrowing your money. You buy the bond from them, you give the government your money, and they give you like 2%. I'm not sure exactly what it is right now. Things are always fluctuating, isn't it great? Now, the way my history teacher or financial, one of my professors, who knows? I feel bad not remembering his or her name, but they said the only way you won't get your money back from the U.S. government is if we see foreign tanks rolling down the street. And yeah, I think that's a great way to remember it, right? So you're going to get your money back. It's risk-free because the only way the U.S. government won't pay their money back is if it doesn't exist anymore. So generally that is less risk, less return. So you get lower returns on that, but there's zero risk. You invest in risky startups like Uber and Netflix, right? You're going to have greater returns because you took on greater risk. They have a higher likelihood of returning more to you in capital appreciation than the government does. So just some points to keep on your radar. Risk and return are highly correlated and can't have one without the other. Hey there, are you ready to not only pass your CPA exams, but truly understand and enjoy the material while studying? I know it seems impossible, right? Especially to enjoy the material? We'll do it together. Tap into the power of cpa.examprep.ai, where we've got personalized quizzes, multiple choice questions, memorization guides, flashcards, simulations, all tailored to your learning. Our adaptive study planning puts you on the fastest path to success and lifts you back up if you fall behind. Avoid wasting your precious time and money attempting an exam with a low chance of passing, because who wants that? We want to get you through this process as quick as possible. Our exam readiness prediction lets you walk in with confidence, knowing that you're prepared for success on exam day. Thankfully, there's no payment method needed to get started. So why don't you come join us? Visit cpa.examprep.ai and let's achieve your exam success together.